And good morning, gang. It's Saturday, the 4th of July, 2015. Welcome to this morning's United... Well, this afternoon's United Kingdom Talk. I seem to have been having a bit of a trouble with the air conditioning at the moment. It's not happening. Oh, hang on a minute. It's on... I don't understand the... You see, this thing's got all symbols on it here. And I don't know what means. So, hang on. I think I've got it on... There it goes. Oh, there it goes. That's it. Has anyone got one of these things? Air conditioning thing. On the symbols here, there's a little triangle. This is for the mode, okay? There's a little triangle at the top. Then there's like a snowflake, which I've just switched it on and it started working. Then there is like three little lines and a sun thing. And then there's like a drop. What does that mean? Anyone know? Does anyone understand? Air conditioning. Oh, that's lovely. Cool air. What's the vents thing? What is the vents thing? The little three. Where are you? You're on Periscope. Right, that thing there. What is that? That's what it was on, the lines, yeah, and nothing was happening. But I put it onto the snowflake and it's word into action now. Anyone? Let me have a look. No, they're not doing anything, they're just open. Oh, hang on, no. No, they're flapping up and down now, my flaps are moving. So that's working now, is it? So what happens if I put it back onto the flaps? Just a minute. Can I? Sorry, talk amongst yourselves for a second. I want to get this working. What? Right, so now I've put it on the flaps. Oh, and the whirring stopped. But the flaps are open. So what's it doing now? The flaps are open. I've had this 10 years and I don't know how it works. The flaps are open, but nothing's whirring round. So what does that mean? I can't be doing anything now, can it? What if I put... What's the drop? What's the thing at the bottom? The little, like... It's like a raindrop. One minute. Let's put it on there. A raindrop. No. Oh, hang on. Flaps are opening. Right, so... So now, well, hang on a minute. Now that, oh, air's coming out. I don't know what that is. What is the raindrop? Does anyone know? Right, and is there a problem with the clothing today, dear? Burgundy and green don't go. We need bright colours. What's wrong with you? Am I not very loud today? Turn me up a bit then. Turn it up, Rusty. Am I loud enough for everyone else? Or am I loud? My meters are telling me I'm at the correct thing. What's wrong with this? Oh, just a minute then. Let me get another. What about grey? Will a grey jacket do? What's wrong with you all today? For God's sake, honestly. Huh? Do you want me to get a grey one? All right, just a second. Do you want a bit of... Just give me a little bit. I'll tell you what, I'll play this. Give me a bit, all right? 1 minute. Back, is that better? Does that kind of work better or what? You know I've never been any good at blooming fashion or anything like that. Okay, good. All right then. This one I've had this for quite a while now. I've got my grey jacket on now. And I bought it for my Who was it first? My niece. I think it was my niece first. I can't remember who got married first, my niece or my nephew. And they were just weeks apart. I think that's working now. Has that got cold air coming out? Hang on. Oh, yes. That's it. That's working now. Thank you, Terry. Terry, could you send me some instructions on this? Oh, I might be able to get this out of the... off the internet when I something like that. There we are, sports coverage. That's better. Well, a happy 4th of July to American friends today. It's their anniversary, isn't it? Their anniversary of independence. Happy anniversary to everyone on the 4th of July in the United States. Is there a special song that I could sing for that? Or do you have to work it out yourself, Terry? Talking of symbols on things and like this, it's like, so much stuff now has little symbols. Have you noticed that? And you look at these symbols. Firework. I don't think that would be appropriate. No. There must be like a song that they sing in America on Independence Day. So many stuff has got little symbols on it. And you look at these symbols and I'll be, you know, gobsmacked if I can understand what any of them mean. Even ironing things and that sort of thing. God bless America. Well, I don't know if I've got that one. I'll have a look at it. Didn't Barry sing that once? Barry Manilow. What's that one he sings? Da 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 da. You know that one he sung at the White House a couple of times? Yes, I have seen the video. So does anyone understand what the symbols mean on anything anymore? Ironing, washing. They're just little squares and diamonds and things like that. And no one's got a clue what these things mean. Who gets the money for coming up with these ideas of replacing sentences with stupid symbols that no one can understand? And you know why they do it, don't you? It's to save on the little bit of material that they sew into an item of clothing, isn't it? That's what it is. So that instead of having like a large label, they can save a bit of money on the material by printing triangles and squares and circles with a bit of hair on and triangles with a moustache on. And no one knows. Anne says it took me 3 weeks to work out my washing machine. Oh, that's easy, Anne. No, that's easy. What you do is just put it on number 4 for everything. That's it. My sister, I'd say I've always bought simple washing machines. Or by that Barry Manilow record was Ring Freedom Ring, wasn't it? Or something like that. Wonderful song. Look that up on YouTube. When I finish, not now. Dear me, Ring Freedom Ring or something like that. Was Let Freedom Sing. Let Freedom Ring. Oh, Let Freedom Ring. Thank you, Wendy. Wonderful. So very, very patriotic. That's what we need in this country. Someone like Barry. Barry could move here, couldn't he? Barry Manilow, and take over. All singing everywhere. All singing and dancing. Anyway, washing machines, yes. I have always bought the simplest washing machine you can possibly buy. Usually an Indesit. I've had a couple of Indesits over the years. They last a reasonable amount of time. And that's all you need. That's all you need. Just switch it on to number 4, okay? And all the washing goes in that. I have learnt, only recently, to always separate the whites from the multicoloured washing. That does work quite well, actually, separating that. But apart from that, everything goes in number 4, which I think is cool wash 40 degrees. And it always comes out nice. I don't believe it's the water anyway. The heat of the water isn't what does it. It's the quality of the washing powder, dear. That's what it is. The quality of the washing powder. And I say washing powder. I've actually stopped buying washing powder now. At the moment, I've got a couple of bottles of Sainsbury's, what do you call it? Sainsbury's washing liquid in a bottle. And that is lavender flavour. Quite nice smell, lavender flavour. I like the smell of lavenders. Okay? And I also have these aerial liquid tablets, which Terry H uses. Aerial liquid tablets. I don't know what flavour they are. I haven't smelt those yet. Mandy uses bulb. Flavour, yeah, different flavours they do, don't they? Of course I don't drink it. It's lavender flavour, that's what it is. It's nice. And I also, yes indeed, I do use fabric conditioner. And the thing is, like, fabric conditioner and washing liquid. Now, they've just started flavouring the washing liquid. As it is a flavour. They've just started flavouring. Eloise, do try and stay with us, dear. You must upgrade your internet connection to provide you permanent on rather than on off every 5 minutes, if you don't mind. So they've started flavouring the washing up liquid as well now, haven't they? The washing liquid as well. They have. But does it matter if you get the two flavours mixed up with the washing liquid and the fabric conditioner? Because there's 101 beautiful, beautiful, lovely, lovely smelling fabric conditioners, isn't there? Scent. That's a good word. Scent. And I would like to send you to prison. I do like the different smells and all that. So does it matter? Are you supposed to match up the washing liquid with the fabric conditioner? What if you put in lavender washing liquid and orange fabric conditioner? And then you could also buy these little balls now. Have you seen those? Tiny little balls. They're like ball bearings. And again, they're different flavours. Now, the idea with those is that you scoop some of those in, just in the washing machine, and it's supposed to make the washing smell for much longer. I love them. Oh, they do such nice smells. They really are. We might be discussing fabric conditioner later on, yes. I haven't decided yet. I don't. Well, I had no intention of at all of discussing fabric conditioning, really. It's just come out. For some reason. How is that? Oh yeah, we've talked about washing machines. So it all goes on number 4 on my Indesit washing machine, which is cool wash 40 degrees. Thank you. And everything works fine. It does. So God bless America. Do we need to sing that today? Let's have a look. Let me try it for the Americans, darling. I'll have a quick look on here and see if we can do it. Scent balls, is that what they're called? They're really nice. God bless America. I don't know if I know the words. One moment, please. Let's try this one. It's in D major, this one. I don't know if I'll be able to do this or not. We'll have a go. One moment, please. God. America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her. With a light above. I don't know. I'm really, really sorry. I don't know the words to that. I don't know the word. Oh, shut up, Ant! I don't know the words to that at all. I'm sorry. Let me try another one. Let's try another one. Let freedom ring. Let's try that one, because I know that one, because Barry sings it, doesn't he? One moment, please. Let's see if that one's here. Oh, there's no words on that one. Oh, God. No, I don't think I'm going to be able to help. Independence Day. No. No, I can't do it. I'm sorry. Really, I can't do it, I'm afraid. I'm sorry. Does anyone want to ring in and sing Let Freedom Ring? Or one of those? One of the Americans, of course. That might be an idea. I'm sorry, boys and girls. I did try then. Thank you very much to Kelly, who sent in just now. No, it's not. No, because it's Independence Day, dear. Independence Day. Who sent in a load of little icons from different symbols. Use water, still use water. What? No, don't put your hands in. Don't wash ever. 30 degrees hot. Thank you very much. That will hopefully assist me in my ironing skills and things like that. All right? Once again, I spent a few minutes today looking for glasses. Has anyone got any tips at all on how to keep your glasses in front of you at all times. That's very, very important. Because I keep losing these. Today, they appeared in the kitchen. I don't believe I ever take them out of this room. That's a thing. Right? And there they were in the kitchen. Perhaps there is some sort of, you know, goblin or dwarf in this house moving things around while I'm asleep. And I'm not a particularly light sleeper. Or heavy sleeper, rather. You know, if there is a noise, I suddenly burst into life. So is there someone in here moving my glasses around as we speak? It's very, very worrying. Now, what have we got here today? Has anyone been watching the TV series on Channel 4, which I've only done... Oh, by the way, can you hear us all right, Rusty? Is it okay for you now? Did you turn it up or something, darling? Sorry, my love. I don't know if you sorted that out, my love. I should have just checked. Is anyone watching that TV series on Channel 4, Humans? Fantastic. I just discovered it. Thank you, Rusty. I just discovered this yesterday afternoon. Terry's watching it. Great. One of my friends, Richard, who popped over yesterday for a pizza at Pizza Hut. He'd just been on holiday from the Isle of Wight, was telling me that Colin Morgan, who's a favourite actor of mine, he was in a TV series called Merlin. I don't know if you saw that at all. Oh, just a moment. We've got a call coming in there. Good morning. Who's on line 200-765?
What?
Good morning. Who's on line 2,000,565?
You what?
Do you want to try once more? No, nothing? How strange. Aren't people strange? Why didn't he talk? Do you think he might have got a wrong number? So this programme, Humans, I only discovered yesterday, and I've already watched the first two episodes. I've got to watch the third episode this afternoon when I have dinner after I've finished our little show today. And I'm really looking forward to that. And it's basically about robots that are very, very much like humans. And they walk around and they're programmed to perform whatever tasks you want. So, of course, we've got some people in the kitchen doing stuff like that. There's one that is like a care assistant. So they're programmed to do certain things. And they look really, really lifelike. It's really, really good. And you must watch it. Humans Channel 4. It's available on that Channel 4 catch-up. What is it called? On-demand thing. 4OD. And the thing is, with the BBC iPlayer, often they have stuff on there and it's only available for like a week. But on Channel 4, the last three episodes are already on there. I've seen the first two. It's really, really good. Science fiction type thing, you know. And I thought to myself, what a wonderful idea to have like a robot, a human-like robot called Synths. S-Y-N-T-H-S. They are called Synths. What a fantastic idea to have a human-type robot like that in the house performing your everyday tasks that they want you to do, that you want them to do. For example, the ironing. Now, come on, Terry. I'm sure you don't like ironing. There's probably people watching this programme now who do not like ironing. Well, I'm one of them. I don't do it. I actually pay someone to do mine, give them all the shirts, and it's done. Wonderful, dear. But they could do everything. Make your tea. They would be programmed to make you the perfect cup of tea in the way that you want it, wouldn't they? None of this, you know, when you go, oh, here's another phone call. Just a moment, please. Good morning. Line 7. Can I help?
Hi, it's Hank from San Diego.
Hello, Ant. How are you today?
I'm good. Happy 4th of July, anyway.
Yes.
To you and all your listeners.
Can you sing the American, what was that song called? God Bless America. Do you know that song? We need
to
do it.
I have something lined up for you. If everyone out there could just stand and put their hand across their chest towards their heart. And I thought I would just sing this for you and your listeners. Are you ready?
We're ready. We're ready for you to sing.
Okay, thanks, my man. Okay, hold on one sec. say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Oh, the sacred rhythm through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. It goes high now. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs burst in air, gave clue. The band can't keep up with me. Tonight, that our flag was silver. Nearly finished, Chris, don't worry. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave. Oh, God.
I think you might have changed the words there, dear.
Well, I only do it once a year on 4th of July. Well, it's a customary. My mom, we have some apple pie and we have some turkey and we celebrate in the true American way.
Well, Rusty says she heard all the right notes there, unfortunately in the wrong order.
Well, my wife, who's from England, I married an English girl, my
England.
Wife, and basically, she knows the words better than me, and I was born and bred in San Diego. What do you think about that, Chris?
Well, isn't that strange? I don't know if they were the right words you were singing those, though.
Well, no, I think I got most of them right, but I think the words Chris Reardon is not in the original.
I don't think so either. There was a film out recently, I don't know if you saw it, called Who Do You Know Chris Reardon or something like that. I've got that film lined up on the...
I watched that.
Did you watch it?
And that's
it?
From SCTV fan.
That's right,
he's a
yes.
pal of mine.
Yes.
And his name is Chris, same as yours. And I had a conversation actually about that video,
right.
not with you, just me and him, because he asked all the ladies if they'd heard of Chris Reardon, and they all said no. But you are a man's man. The men like you in lots of different ways.
Thank you very much. Do you think
yes.
so?
Yeah, well, I like you in lots of different ways, absolutely.
Oh,
and,
right.
And the thing is, Chris, if he would have done a fair cross-section across all the states, he just picked one little road in little old Mississippi and basically asked a few ladies. Now, if he would have gone to Washington, New York,
yes.
you know, all over, you are becoming a phenomenon, my friend.
I thought that as well. I think where he went, they don't have television there.
They don't have... I was going to swear. No, they don't have lots of stuff where
no,
he's from.
No,
you know, they don't have a McDonald's. They don't have obesity. You know, that's what we're all about here, Chris. We're about McDonald's. We're about fat kids. We're about lots more than people give us credit for.
Love. That's what it's all about. Love. Love.
Well, as someone once sang, all you need is love.
All you need is love.
Love.
La, 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 la. Yeah, that's the one. That's the one.
That is the one. Well, I got to shoot now because I'm watching the Red Sox later. But I just wanted to wish all your listeners a very happy Independence Day from San Diego and from everywhere in the United States. God bless you and God bless America and God bless Obama.
Thank you, San Diego. Goodbye.
What's that, my friend?
Thank you, San Diego.
Yeah, God bless you. We love you.
God bless you too. Bye-bye.
Bye now.
Oh, how lovely to have a God bless at the end. You see, there was someone out there who was able last... Oh, how fantastic. That's better, isn't it? How much better is that, my darlings? Fantastic. I do feel that we've now celebrated the 4th of July correctly here on this programme. How marvellous. And I like the... I must say, it was quite funny. Just going back to last Saturday, something different here. And I meant to mention this on one of the Periscopes this week. One of my Manolo friends, Angela Washington, I think it was, lovely lady who I met a couple of years ago in Florida. She said... because it was the gay pride thing last week, and she said, you all make me laugh on here. Pretty rainbows and pretty flowers all over the place, wishing each other love, and the moment yet in reality everyone's stabbing each other in the back. And do you know how true that is, Angela? That's so true. Everyone did their little pride thing with the rainbow thing going across their flat. I didn't do any of that, dear. They are all stabbing each other in the back, and that all the blooming time. I don't know. Let's see. Oh, no show next Saturday, okay? No show next Saturday, boys and girls. Going up to visit my sister, so there won't be a show next week, okay? Now, here's a little item I got in the newspaper this morning. See what you think of this. Cutting out the middleman. Beer brewed from recycled something to go on sale at festival. Now, have you any idea what they're going to recycle to make beer? Any idea at all? Any clues? No? Any idea? Anyone seen the story yet? Correct, Ant. In the Daily Mail this morning, festival goers in Denmark are being asked to donate their urine to make beer. I'm not making that up. The unusual project will repurpose up to 25,000 litres of urine from 100,000 people at the festival to create 425 kegs. Terry has already said he will try it. You see, the mention of alcohol, and his little ears come up like that, and he's typing away on that key. Can't stop typing now. Where is it? Where is it? I want to try it. As soon as you mention alcohol, Terry is there. You know, there was one point that he disappeared for quite a few shows and we didn't see him anywhere. And then I mentioned alcohol. God, he was back there like a flash within a couple of minutes. It says the urine will be stored and taken to nearby fields where it will be used to fertilise barley. So what? There's no difference really here, is there? There really isn't difference, Wendy. So the barley's growing and they pour all the wee over it. Maybe I should do that to my flowers. Is it good for flowers? Instead, you know, and I could save money on the water that flushes the toilet, couldn't I? By just going out into the garden and weeing on my plants. Should I try that? Does anyone know if that's a good idea or not? I mean, I don't really put any fertiliser on there. I water the plants daily. I don't put the sprinkler on, ever, on the grass. Don't need to do that. I did that for quite many years. I mean, many, many years. I used to put the sprinkler, and sometimes I put it on in the afternoon. Terry reckons I should try that. Weeing on my plants. Dogs do it, the plants die, do they? I haven't got a dog. I've got a cat. There's nothing dead. But human wee on plants, is that a good idea? Your suggestions, please. Now, you can call in if you want to, boys and girls. There is a Skype. Skype username, all one word. United Kingdom Talk. United Kingdom Talk is the Skype in. There's also a phone number as well, if you'd like to call in. 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. Just in case there might be someone that wants to call in about this today. Would you try it? You see, they're not doing it directly, Wendy. Your wee is not directly being turned into beer. What they're doing is weeing on the barley. The barley grows, the barley is made into beer. It's no different, is it? You are drinking
the Wii of dinosaurs. It just keeps going round. That stuff that you pull the chain in the toilet and goes down the tube, what do you think happens to that? It goes to a treatment centre, it's treated, it goes back through all these layers of sand and stuff like that, comes back down the pipes, goes into the river, gets sucked back out of the river, and is made into drinking water. Who's going to stop drinking water? Don't buy that bottled water. Now, what? Don't waste your money on bottled water. God's sake, I see these people in supermarkets, don't you? And they've got, you know, 20 bottles of water. Why? Why have you got 20 bottles of water? You do sparkling wee, do you, Terry? That's interesting. Terry does sparkling wee, which they then turn into sparkling water, apparently. How interesting. Don't waste your money on bottled water. Get these people, oh, there's all sorts of stuff in there. Let me tell you, the water that comes out of the tap, I believe, is probably better than the water in plastic bottles all over the place. What a waste of money and plastic that is. Bottled water. I mean, you can understand it. Certainly in this country, we're okay. There are other countries where the hygiene of water isn't so good. So, you know, I would never ask you to not drink bottled water in, say, countries. Actually, I can't think. Well, America. You're not supposed to drink the water out of the tap in America. Is that right? And your old water pipes. You're right, Terry. Old water pipes. Spain is a place. You've got to drink bottled water in Spain. But old water pipes. Think of that. Some of these water pipes we've got here in the UK, they're made out of old... aren't they some of them made out of lead? So I suppose that's coming out of your tap, isn't it, when you think about it? But I don't buy bottled water. Only if I'm abroad, and I'll check first. I say, can I drink the tap water? And they'll either say yes or no. No problem at all, you know. It goes on here. Men are asked to urinate into a metal... frog bits in Glossop. Oh, do you get frog bits when you turn your tap on? I've got a frog living in my under my plants at the moment. Little baby frog. When I water the plants, he jumps out and has a quick look at me and then jumps back behind the leaves again. Ah, bless. Leave him there, dear. Get the spiders. Get the spiders and the flies. Will you walk into the parlour, said the spider to the fly. Men are asked to urinate into a metal trough with a sign reading, don't waste your piss. Danish farmers can turn it into beer again. For women, card urine directors are being handed out to them to add to the hall. Now, I've seen one of these, especially for ladies, a card urine directors, and I'll make one in front of you now, okay? I will. You won't believe this. So for the ladies, right, it's a bit like this, okay? I've seen these things. Is that DJ Jeff there? Right, so they're a bit like a funnel, and ladies, you simply put them over the hole, and then you can point, just like we can. And when you're in toilets, public toilets, you can chase the cigarette ends all around the urinal as you're going. Hours of entertainment for nothing. You know how much fun you can have doing that. I went in 5 times in an hour once just to chase around cigarette ends. Of course, we can't do it now in pubs because they stop the smoking. They just remove all the fun from weeing, don't they? The story goes on. We've got urinals right next to the stages where acts will play, so we're hoping to collect some rock star wee as well. And the story goes on. So actually, I don't think there's anything wrong with that, you know, weeing on plants. And the plants are just filtering it out, aren't they? As you go along. Would I drink something directly made out of it? Probably not. But there's probably actually no difference, is there? It just gets recycled into something else. Now, I was just talking about that programme, Humans, that I'm watching on Channel 4 at the moment. And it reminded me of a sign I keep seeing all over the place in London. This is the latest O2, you know, the mobile telephone company, the latest O2 advertisement, which is now saying, if you have an O2 phone with O2 priority, which I think is a theatre ticket thing as well. The O2 in London. If you've got an O2 phone, you're supposed to get certain benefits in having that O2 phone if you go to the O2 arena. Well, the latest thing is, if you have an O2 priority account type thing, right, you can watch, are you ready for this? You can watch Channel 4 shows 48 hours before everyone else. How exciting is that? That's what they're selling it on. Being able to watch Channel 4 shows 2 days before everyone else. Now, I've got to ask you, is that doing it for you? Because I looked at that and I thought, are you seriously taking the mick here? You think I would get an O2 phone just so that I can watch shows 2 days before everyone else? Three buying O2. Oh, God, three. Don't get me started on them. I had a three phone, must be about 18 years ago. Their customer service was diabolical. It was the worst customer service I've ever had, Terry. All right when it's working. The moment it goes wrong, you try and get that phone. It might be different now, but you know, with big companies, once they've peed me off, that's it. I'm gone, mate. I'm gone. Wendy had the same as well. You know, Wendy, I don't know if you know, many, many, many years ago, when I was 15 or 16, one of those two, I had a Philips cassette recorder, which went wrong. And they sent it back. With the adapter, it came back without the adapter. And my dad rowed in this shop because they wouldn't replace it. And then they said, oh, well, we'll go halves with you. No, we sent an adapter off. Why isn't it here? And I never, ever bought another item from Philips. Once I'm peed off with a company, that's it. I'm gone, mate. I'm gone. And it's the same with three. I don't care if they've put another 1,000 customer services people in to answer the phones. You really peed me off. I will never ever buy another item from three. It was a disaster, an absolute disaster. Good morning, Chris. Thanks for joining us a little later than everyone else. Well done for hauling that old carcass out of your bed and joining us this morning. So that's three. So, I don't know how sad you must want to be. Terry says, doesn't that attitude restrict your options? Everyone deserves a second chance. Probably, yes, but I'm not giving them a second chance. Why would I give them a second chance? Any company, a second chance. Once you've mucked me about, that's it, I'm gone, Terry. No, no, no. And they get away with it because people give them second chances, Terry. No second chance. No. Stubborn. Stubborn. No. No. No, 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 no. No second chances. Yeah, so, I mean, how sad must you be to want to buy a mobile phone that is showing, just so that you can watch programmes 48 hours before everyone else? Chris, if you'd have been with us earlier, then you would know what we're talking about, dear. <laughs> 48 hours, you're going to get an O2 phone? Just so you can watch the shows a little bit before everyone else? What a stupid advert. Stupid, stupid advert. Another story here. We were talking about signs earlier. Little triangles and squares and things like that. That you find all over the place, including on my air conditioning, which I don't understand. Here's one. Mind how you go. Swiss railway posts signs explaining how to use the toilet because Asian tourists don't use them properly. We're talking about a lot of toilets today, I'm afraid. I don't know how that's happened. Probably bad getting ready stuff from me. We're not having the disco lights on today, Terry. It's daytime, dear. We don't do discos during the day. Switzerland takes pride in its approach to cleanliness, and it now aims to extend that message to certain foreigners who are not familiar with the ways of Western toilet etiquette. A series of signs, apparently aimed at visitors from Southeast Asia and the Middle East, explain how one should sit on a loo seat rather than squat, and throw toilet paper into the lavatory rather than into the bin. Oh, God, I feel ill. And the picture, basically, is a person sitting on the toilet like that, with a little tick next to it, and another picture of someone with their 2 feet on the bowl, squatting on the toilet, and that's got an X next to it there. Because they don't use toilets like we do. It says, it happens that guests mount on the toilet seats to do their business, and sometimes they don't know where to put the toilet paper. Now, I know quite a member of, quite a lot of people who work for British Airways. That's not to say I get cheap airfares or free upgrades. There are people out there who are always trying to get something for nothing. I know someone in BA, I can get a free upgrade. I know someone for Air Canada, I can get a free upgrade. Always these something for nothing people out there. No, I have to pay full price. I wouldn't have the cheek and audacity to go, oh, hello, Mark, I'm going over to Australia. Any chance of an upgrade if I just buy the economy? I just couldn't do that. Couldn't do it. It says, it's happened that people relieve themselves in the shower rather than in the toilet, and Switzerland isn't the only country cracking down on the issue. Now, what I'm saying here, I know people for British Airways, and they say the worst flight they do is the one to Bangladesh. Now, this isn't to say that anyone's not doing something wrong from Bangladesh, okay? But they do it differently to us. So before people start screaming racist, which they usually do because they're not listening to the whole bloody conversation, shut your mouths for 5 minutes and listen. When they do these flights to Bangladesh, they have to keep, the British Airways staff have to keep going in the toilet and cleaning up, because what people do is they do their business in the toilet paper and then leave it on the side because they don't know. No one's taught them. It's not their fault. Not pleasant, really, is it for us? But we don't do that. They do that. We don't. We do stuff. They don't. That's how it is. So they have to keep going in and telling them, clearing up, because they just never, they don't, I suppose they don't have toilets like we have. Indeed, I seem to remember years ago, I think, in France, and there was no, I think I went there with a school or something, and we went in to use a public toilet. And it wasn't like a sit-down toilet. It was like just a hole in the ground, and you 1 foot either side. Chris says, in Greece, you have to put the toilet paper in a bin. And in Spain as well, really. gosh. It must stink, though. Oh, God, no. I can't wait to flush that chain once I've finished here. It's awful, awful. Anyway, so that's another little story there. Oh, good news so far. So far, so good. Now, you remember on Tuesday, I was driving home from the Golden Lion. Highly successful, that karaoke. I see what's wrong with that one. I cancelled that night. And the lady, Mary, asked me to go back to do a one-off for the dance. And since then, there's been another three. And they've all been busy. I actually got that one wrong. I cancelled it because I didn't think it was going to work. I was wrong. I was wrong. It worked. Anyway, coming back from the Golden Lion on Tuesday, for a millisecond, I took my eye off the ball and I went too fast past a speed camera by about 2 miles an hour. I say 2 miles an hour. Yeah, I think it was about probably about two or 3 miles an hour, something like that. Anyway, it flashed. That was on Tuesday. And I do not speed. It's very, very rare. I mean, I just don't. Even on the motorway, I do about 60 miles an hour. All these blooming lorries are right up my arse sometimes, you know, if there's roadworks. Because roadworks, we've got roadworks at the moment on the M3. And the thing is, at night time, you're down to one lane in parts of it, right? And on the left-hand side, there's cones, which is fine. But on the right-hand side, they have this piece, this long barrier made of concrete. And for some reason, I really dislike this long concrete barrier. It's scared. I just keep thinking, any minute now, I'm going to scrape along the side of that or go into it. I don't know why. Because I'm not the same with the metal barriers. You know the metal barriers they've got in the middle of the motorways? If I'm overtaking someone in the far right-hand overtaking lane, I don't have a problem with that metal barrier. But for some reason, that concrete thing in the middle, when you've got that on one side and the cones on the other, scares me. And I slow down to about 50 in a 50 zone, okay? Usually when they've got those single lanes in the motorway, it goes down to 50 mile an hour and I stick to that 50. Sometimes dropping a little below that. These bloody great juggernauts are coming up behind you, flashing their lights like that. All the time. I rarely, rarely speed. But on Tuesday, took my eye off the ball and I got flash. That was Tuesday. So we've had Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Just a minute. I'm just going to check now.
Nope, nothing there yet. Nope.
Nothing there yet. So I'm hoping that this was one of those cameras that don't work. But I might be wrong. It was also on a light, so it was a red light camera. But I gather some of the red light cameras also perform as speed cameras as well. Is that right? Chris Jackson, is it still 3? Is what still 37? What's 37? I did do a speed awareness course, that's right, about 2 years ago. Very, very boring. And the trouble with these speed awareness courses, you can do them and put up with them. And if everyone sat there quietly and just listened to the person who was taking the speed awareness course, then we'd all be out of there in a couple of hours. But no, you always get some earhole that decides to ask questions. Why do they do that? Why do they do that? Someone gets up and starts asking these blooming questions. Oh, it does get on my nerves. Got a message coming in here. Thank you very much to Kelly for the information there. She says on the subject of humans, we're watching humans. It's brilliant. Oh, it's Richard's partner. Hello, Kelly. All right. Can't wait for tomorrow's episode. Think there's going to be a dark side to it. Apparently, the show originated in Holland and ours is a remake. Oh, I didn't know that. Is it really? Oh, righty-ho. I had no idea that was a remake of something in Holland. But it's very, very good. Wendy's done two two speed awareness courses and actually enjoyed them. Think there's something wrong with me? Yeah, there is. There is. When seriously, oh, you weren't the person who stands up and starts asking questions, were you, Wendy? Please don't tell me you were that person. So no speeding ticket yet. So I'm quite pleased about that. Just do one more little story here, and then we'll disappear tonight. Now, who was up late last night or got woken up by the amazing thunderstorms we had last night? I was driving home last night at about 1 o'clock in the morning, I think I was, and coming on the M4, and wow, I mean, the lightning I saw above me last night was quite magnificent. It was just like a lightning storm in Florida. Now, I've spoken about those before on the show. If you want to see a proper lightning storms, go to Florida around June. And you will see them several times a day. Fantastic displays, just like we had last night. Lightning, joining up, joining together, coming down to the ground. Totally amazing and also very frightening at the same time. Well, I saw this last night. In London, it was really bad. I mean, really bad. Torrential rain. We slowed down right on the road. Very, very slow because you just couldn't see the road at one point. It was coming down so heavy, the rain. And I thought my water butts might be filled up when I was here. But actually here, it doesn't look like we had as much rain as there was last night, certainly over London. Because if I get a very heavy storm here, my two very large water butts fill up very quickly. They really do. They fill up very quickly. But they didn't last night. So that was a shame. In the Daily Mail again, spectacular displays of lightning and thunderstorms triggered by the heatwave battered Britain overnight. And I think there was something now. I saw. Let me see if I can find that there. Can I find that there? Here we are. There was another little story, BuzzFeed News, that said last night at around. Let me see if I can find that. The BBC weather reporter this morning said there'd been 110,000 lightning strikes across the country last night between 8 p.m. and 8 a.m. That's a big storm for us. You probably get it in the States quite a lot more than we do. And it says, yellow, be aware warning issued by Met Office for today and parts of Britain. We may get flooding today. Someone's house hit fire there. I saw that in the story. They saw that in the story as well. In the paper yesterday, I saw someone's house. The roof totally destroyed, big hole in there and everything burnt inside. Must be very scary. You've got to be really unlucky to be hit by lightning, though, apparently. I mean, here I'm surrounded by tall pine trees. I suppose more chance of one of those getting struck than my house because, you know, they're like three times the size of the house, aren't they? Anyway, gang, that's it for today. Thank you very much for joining me. I got to say, doing this long show on YouTube and Periscope at the time, at the same time. Having it on Periscope at the same time is really off-putting, if you see what I mean. I quite like doing the Periscope shows as little Periscope shows, if you see what I mean. You know, just little Periscope shows to maybe a couple of times a day, as I do. But I also like doing the YouTube show where you kind of choose things and then you start talking about them. But as I look down at the other thing, it's really distracting. And I think I'm going to separate the Saturday one. I'm going to separate. I'm not going to do the Saturday live show on Periscope anymore because it's just completely off-putting. Really off-putting. You can't be talking about something and then all the time comments coming in Do you see what I mean? It's just it's impossible to do it in the format that I was doing it by having it going up on the Periscope at the same time. So I think what we'll do from the next Saturday show, it'll just be on the YouTube again. I think we can carry on with the Periscope as it is, you know, because it's a great thing. Or I could just have it on there and not look at messages and carry on like that. But then Periscope, I don't think that would work, would it? Eh? Anyway, thank you very much today, boys and girls. That's it for the show. Have a lovely, lovely Saturday and a lovely Sunday. I've got a day off tomorrow. I'm so excited. A day off tomorrow. Another one, yes. I like to have them now and again. See you later. Thanks. Bye-bye now.